Now, today we will discuss the post-fertilization events. Means after fertilization, what are the events occurs? In last class, we studied the double fertilization in angiosperm. And now, today we will discuss after fertilization, what are the events occurs after fertilization? The events occurs after fertilization are development of endosperm and the development of embryo, formation of seed and formation of fruits. So these are the post-fertilization events. After double fertilization, zygote develop to form embryo, while primary endosperm cell develop to form endosperm. And the complete ovule develop into the seed and the ovary changes into the fruit. And the other parts like sepals, petals, stigma, style, they are fall off. But before development of embryo, endosperm development occurs because endosperm is the nutritive tissue which provide nutrition for the development of embryo. Endosperm is the nutritive tissue that provide nutrition for developing embryo. So there is a question that endosperm development precedes embryo development. That is, the endosperm development occurs earlier than the development of embryo from zygote. So why endosperm development occurs before the development of embryo? Because endosperm provide nutrition for the development of embryo from zygote. So that's why endosperm development occurs before the development of embryo. In most of the plants, endosperm development is free nuclear. The primary endosperm nucleus, that is the primary endosperm nucleus, this is the, and this is the central cell, that is called the primary endosperm cell. The antipodal cells degenerate, synergids also degenerate. So in the central cell, there is one zygote, and this is the primary endosperm cell having the primary endosperm nucleus. Now, this primary endosperm cell, or this is the central cell, this developed to form the nutritive tissue called the endosperm to provide nutrition to developing embryo from zygote. But the most common type of endosperm development is free nuclear endosperm development. In most of the organisms, most of the angiosperms, this primary endosperm nucleus divides repeatedly to form the thousands of nuclei and forms the free nuclear endosperm. And then after cellularization or cell wall formation occurs, and then it changes into the cellular endosperm. For example, in coconut, there is the water in the center. This water is actually free nuclear endosperm, while the white part found around the coconut, that is the kernel that we eat, that is the cellular endosperm, that is the multicellular endosperm. Because cellularization or cell wall formation occurs from the periphery towards center, so that's why the cellular endosperm now found around the coconut that we eat, and gradually the water that present in the center that gradually changes into the cellular indoor sperm. So this coconut water is actually the free nuclear indoor sperm. So in many, this is the most common type of endosperm development, in which the first free nuclear endosperm formation occurs, in which the primary endosperm nucleus divides repeatedly to form the thousands of nuclei, and then cell wall formation occurs from periphery towards the center. For example, in coconuts. So coconut water is actually the free nuclear endosperm, and the kernel white part that found in the periphery, that is the cellular endosperm. Now we will talk the embryo development. So after endosperm development, embryo development occurs, in which the zygote cell now divide to form the embryo. So this is, suppose this one is a zygote cell, this is the zygote, and now first of all this zygote cell divide transversely to form unequal, two unequal cells. The basal cell is called the suspensor cell, that actually found towards the micropylar end, and the another terminal cell that is called embryo cell, that is found towards the chalazal end. So this zygote, now we are learning the embryo development or embryogeny after endosperm development. So first endosperm development occurs because the endosperm has to provide the nutrition for the development of embryo, and now the embryo development we are going to discuss. So this zygote now divides first transversely to form these two unequal cells. The basal cell, this is called the basal cell or suspensor cell, that lies towards the micropylar end. And the another, this is the terminal cell, also called embryo cell, that lies towards the chalazal end. Now, this suspensor cell, first we will talk about suspensor cell. Now it divides many times to forms the 6 to 8 suspensor cell, and the this one is the called haustorium. This is the large cell, basal, large basal cell, that is called the haustorium, and these are also, these are the suspensor cells. Now, so this, all these suspensor cells occurs due to the this transfer division of this suspensor cell or basal cell, divides repeatedly, forms the 6 to 8 the suspensor cells. And this upper one, this is the larger basal cell, is called the haustorium. And the cell that is the near to the embryonal cell, or this is the last cell of suspensor, this is also called hypophysis. This hypophysis helps in the development of the part of radical and the root cap, or we can say that this hypophysis helps in the formation of a root apical meristem, root cap, part of root cap or part of radical. And now we will talk about this embryonal cell. This is the embryonal cell, now divide to form two-celled proembryo. This is the two-celled proembryo. Again, this two-celled embryo cell, this is the two-celled condition, now again divide to form four-celled proembryo. Now it again divide to form the eight-celled proembryo. This is the eight-celled proembryo. After that, it forms the globular-shaped proembryo, a globular embryo. Here, this is the hypophysis. Hypophysis is the last suspensor cell that we just now we talked here, that is the suspensor cell. This is the hypophysis. This also helps in the formation of the part of root cap and radical. Here, this is the part. And now, in the globular, this is the 8-celled proembryo. Again, it divides to form 16-celled. And now, the cells arranged at this periphery, this is called the dermatogen, finally develop into the epidermis. And now, this is the inner cells that forms the ground meristem, and there is the cells that forms the procambium. So now after this globular proembryo, it now takes the shape of heart shaped embryo. This is the heart shaped embryo. Here this is the suspensor, this is the haustorium, and now this hypophysis divide to form here the part of root cap and the part of radical here. And now this is the heart shaped embryo. This outer layer is the dermatogen. Now this is the ground meristem, and this one is the procambium. And finally this heart shaped embryo finally developed to form a mature dicot embryo. So here we were talking the development of dicotyledonous embryo. So this is the process of the development of dicot embryo. Suppose this is a mature dicot embryo, consists of two cotyledons. This is the two cotyledon. This is the part now grows rapidly. This part of this heart-shaped embryo, you can see here, this part grows rapidly to forms these two cotyledons. Beside these two cotyledons, this is the embryonal axis. This one is called the embryonal axis. In embryonal axis, this the part between this cotyledon, this is called the plumule, and this part is called the radical. And of the radical there is the root cap, and this is the suspensor and haustorium. So this is the mature dicot embryo. So in this whole process, what we learned, that this zygote cell first divide transversely to forms the one suspensor cell or basal cell, and another one is the embryonal cell. This suspensor cell lies towards the micropylar end, and the embryonal cell lies towards the chalazal end. Now this suspensor cell divides repeatedly, forms this 6 to 8 this suspensor cell. This upper one is upper basal cell, is called also called haustorium. And now the last suspensor cell is also called hypophysis, that later on it take part in the formation of a part of root cap and radical, not complete part. So it helps in the formation of some part of root cap and the some part of radical. And now this is the embryonal cell. This embryonal cell divides to form two-celled proembryo, again divide to forms the four-celled proembryo, again it divides to forms the 8-celled proembryo, again 16-celled proembryo, and finally it forms the shape of globular shape. This is called the globular proembryo. After globular, it forms this heart-shaped proembryo, in which the outer layer is the dermatogen that forms the epidermis. And now this is the ground meristem, ground meristematic tissue, and this one is the procambium, and this is the part of root cap and the radical here. Now finally this heart-shaped proembryo developed to form a mature dicot embryo that consists of two cotyledons. There is the plumule, there is the radical root cap, and now this is the cambium strand, a procambial strand. So now we will talk the structure of this dicot embryo. Again we will talk here the structure of dicot embryo. You can see in this diagram, this is the embryonal axis. This one is called the embryonal axis, and these are the two cotyledons. In embryonal axis there is the plumule, there is the radical, this is the hypocotyl, there will be the epicotyl. The epicotyl terminates in the plumule and hypocotyl terminates in the radical. This is the root cap. Now you can see a dicot seed here also. So this is the two cotyledons of a dicot seed, and this one is the embryonal axis. This is the embryonal axis. This is the cotyledonous node here. This is the attachment here. This is the node, and just above this the part, just above is the epicotyl, and the epicotyl terminates in the plumule having the leaf primordia, a small leaf like structure. And from this node the lower part is the hypocotyl, and it terminates in the radical. Radical finally develop into the root system, and the plumule finally develop into the shoot system. Now we will talk the development of monocot embryo. So the early development of this dicot and monocot embryo is similar, but finally only one cotyledon develop in the monocot embryo, that is called the scutellum, and this one is the embryonal axis. This is the embryonal axis. There is the epicotyle, and at the terminal part of epicotyle is the shoot apex, and it is covered by a sheath that is called the coleoptile. So this shoot apex is covered by coleoptile. And now we talk here, this part is the hypocotyle. Now this is the radical, and this is the root cap, and this is also covered by a sheath that is called the coleorhiza. So this coleorhiza and coleoptile is actually, this is the covering that covers the shoot apex and the root cap. This is the covered by this coleoptile and coleorhiza, and it is actually this extension of this scutellum. That so this is the monocot embryo having only one cotyledon, that is called the scutellum. And this is the epiblast. This is the remnant part, ya bacha hua bhag jisko kah sakte, of the second cotyledon, and this is the embryonal axis. So this is the structure of a monocot embryo that contain this single cotyledon, and the part just above the attachment of this cotyledon, this is the epicotyle, and it terminate in the shoot apex covered by the sheath that is called the coleoptile. And now there is the hypocotyle, then this is the radical covered by root cap, and this is also again covered by a sheath that is called the coleorhiza. So this radical and root cap covered by coleorhiza, and now this shoot apex is covered by the coleoptile. This coleoptile and coleorhiza is actually, this is the extension of the cotyledon or scutellum. This is the extension. Now here we can see the seed of monocot seed. You can see here, this is the LS of maize seed. Actually it is not the seed, it is the fruit. This is the fruit actually. So in fruit we can see that this is the outer part is the pericarp, and the ovary completely develop into the fruit. So this is the pericarp, fused pericarp and testa here written. Testa is actually, this is the seed coat. And now this is the endospermic seed, endospermic fruit that contain the endosperm. The outer layer of endosperm is called the eleuron layer, that is rich in protein, while this endosperm is rich in the starch. And now this is the embryonal axis. Here is the plumule, here is the radical. Plumule now covered by this coleoptile, and this radical covered by this coleorhiza. So this is the embryonal axis we can see. This is the endospermic seed, while this one is the non-endospermic seed. Yeah, this is the albuminous seed, and this is the ex-albuminous or non-albuminous seed. Here also we can see another seed also here. This is the seed, onion seed. Now you can see this is also monocotinous seed. There is a single cotyledon. This is the single cotyledon. There is the endosperm. And now this part is the shoot apical meristem here that develop into the shoot. And this is the hypocotyle, and this is the root tip or radical. Root tip or radical. And now this is the shoot apical meristem. So this is the seed of the onion seed. So these both are the seeds of the monocots, but this maize is not actually seed, it is the complete fruit. So today we studied this, the embryo of dicot and monocot, as well as together the dicot seed and these two monocot seeds.